Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to record audio using GarageBand. So I'm using GarageBand version 10 here, and we're going to do one of the simplest things you can do with GarageBand, which is just to simply record some audio from the microphone. So let's start off by choosing an empty project. And we're going to get asked a few things here. One of the choices we want to make is we want to do an audio project and record using a microphone as a line input. It gives me some choices here for my input. It tells me here I've got this microphone selected. I'm using a Mac Pro, so I have a USB microphone selected. If you're using an iMac or a MacBook Pro, then you probably have just the microphone selected there. So this one, I've got some choices here about which input. I could do stereo. I'm just going to stick with the default and hit create, and it will create the GarageBand project for me, and I'm ready to go. You can even see here under audio, it's listening in on my microphone, so it's reacting to my voice. So before I start recording, I want to make sure I turn off the metronome, and also I want to make sure I turn off the count in, so it just starts recording as soon as I hit this record button, then I hit stop when I'm done. Hello, this is a test of recording on GarageBand. Then I can hit stop, I can rewind the playhead, and I could play back.
Hello, this is a test of recording on GarageBand.
Now, I can keep recording here. I've got this playback head, and I can position it wherever I want. So I can put it here at the end, and I can record some more. Some more. And it puts it in there. So this is kind of one track here, and I keep adding to it. I can also select these and remove them, just hitting the delete key, or I can move them around. So I can push this one further out. I could rearrange them like so. So there's a lot I can do. If you want to edit these further, you can. You can actually go here and increase the magnification so I can see the waveform in here. And I can hear what parts these are.
Some more. Hi, this is a test record.
And if I want to, I can actually break pieces out. So I can put the playhead right here, for instance, and right where I want, I can hit split regions, and Command T will do that. And you can see I split this into two pieces. So I could select this one and delete it, or I could move it around. There's a lot of different things that I could do just by splitting up pieces I've done and moving them around and rearranging them and deleting them. And of course, positioning the playhead and starting to record new things wherever I want. You can also filter the voice. So I could select the whole track here just by clicking here. And there are all sorts of things that I could do over here in the library. I could bring this up or close this by hitting this button here. And I could say change the type of vocal to basically kind of brighten it up, make it different, make it edgy. All sorts of things that I could do to work with vocals. There's some more in here, for instance. So a lot you can do, and you can further customize these if you want, and you could download more. So to further edit these controls, I can hit the button over here, bring up all these different controls here that allow me to further customize how my voice is going to sound in this track. And I can adjust these pretty easily, and I can switch to an equalizer view of it if I want. So there's a lot I can do to control these, and it depends on what filter you've selected as to what options that you're going to see here. So I should add, you're also not limited to just one track here. You can add another track. It brings back all of this, and we can create another microphone track there. And you can see I've got this first one and the second one, and I could have the second one selected as I've just clicked on it there. And if I record more audio, I'll be able to just add it here as another track as I record, and I'll even hear my voice from this first track playback. So now we hear a combination of these voices.
Some more.
And there's all sorts of different things that we can do. We could actually bring these segments from one track to another track, have them overlap. So you can do a lot of different things in terms of editing and putting together audio just from recording on the microphone. So now that you've got something recorded, you probably want to export it into an audio file. And of course, you want to save this as a GarageBand project so that you keep all the tracks and everything there and you can go back in and edit it. But you also want to export it to a standard sound file. You can just go directly and send it to iTunes if you want, or you can use the Export Song to Disk option. And this will allow you to save out the file to your documents folder or wherever. And you could choose from a few different quality measurements here, and so we can choose like something lower quality for just voice or higher quality if there's singing involved. You can also choose the AIFF standard file format, which is lossless rather than the MP4 audio format here, which will be a smaller file size, so more ideal for sending over email or something like that. And then you can export that file out, and that file then can be used elsewhere in other programs and video editing, all sorts of different places.